Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, we need to talk about a bunch of updates to the channel, projects, current status of things, and there's some things I really need your help with, so I hope that you stick around for the end of the episode to see what those things are. So first and foremost, as you can see here, I have continued to release updates to my best practices book, and I continue to release more puzzle books. I currently have 5 puzzle books available, and I'm on the second edition of best practices. And of course, if you buy these books on LeanPub, then you get updates to them if I have to publish any corrections. Now, the puzzle books, you've seen them before in other episodes, they're really meant to be written in, so I don't feel like the ebook is the best option for that, but if you have something like a Remarkable tablet or something like that where you can write in the PDF, then that might be a great option for you. Of course, if you do want a print version, these books are all available on Amazon as well. Now, I don't sell Kindle books through Amazon because Amazon takes a giant chunk of my profit if I do it that way. So if you want the ebook, go to LeanPub. If you want the print book, go to Amazon. And all of these links are in the video description below. Now, something I never talk about on this channel is I am actually a Microsoft MVP. This comes up from time to time when I give conference talks and stuff, and people say they have no idea what that means. It basically just means that Microsoft is thanking me for my contribution to the global C++ community, effectively. So I've won this award for 8 years in a row. I'm not an employee of Microsoft. I am not in any way obligated to talk nicely about Microsoft or anything like that. But it gives me access to some internal resources at Microsoft and Microsoft tools that I have available. Now, I am surprised every time that I meet someone who is surprised to learn that I actually do training. Now, I have said in almost every one of my 333 episodes up to this point that my name is Jason Turner, I'm available for code reviews and on-site training, or something along those lines. On-site training means I actually do offer training to companies. That is how I make most of my living. So if you work for a company that uses C++, you have, say, at least 10 developers on your team, and you want my highly interactive, highly customized style of training for your team, then please contact me. There's a million different ways too. You can contact me from my website, and this is again linked in the video description. And that's emptycrate.com. That's not very complicated. Or you can reach out to me on Twitter or Discord or LinkedIn if you would like to. There's a million different ways to get in touch with me. And I do my best to keep up with all of those different ways that people might get in contact with me. I do offer a wide variety of topics for my classes, but generally the way it works with my classes is I send a pre-class survey to the students who will be attending so that I can really get a feel for what their C++ experience level is, and I can tightly customize the class just to those students. So this is a relatively unique way of training, and I think it's worked very well in the past. There have been companies that have had me back multiple times. So I think that you should definitely check this out for your team, and particularly as we are moving to an environment where our teams are more and more distributed geographically, it's a good opportunity to bring everyone into the same place for a few days a year where they can all interact with each other and all benefit from getting unified and having the same conversations about C++ at the same time together. Okay, so the big news item here that you may not have noticed is I have a second channel. I've had it for a long time now. 6 years, in fact, and it was called The Retro Programmer previously. I've decided to rebrand a little bit. Now you can see here, I'm still in the process of unifying my branding in different places. That still says the Retro Programmer. It is now called the Fill in the Blank Programmer, and you can find it by searching for either of these things currently on YouTube, and there should be a link again in the video description. Now, I just wanted an area where I could expand a little bit the topics that I talk about, so it's not just C++ that I'm allowed to talk about. If you're a fan of C++ Weekly, you may have noticed that if I have an episode where I don't talk about C++ specifically, people seem to get a little annoyed. They don't like that episode as much. So this is a place for me to talk about all of the other topics that affect programmers. And I have worked with a wide range of programming languages and tools over the decades that I've been developing, so I can talk about various random things here. Okay, so on to GitHub and the projects. Now, again, I'm in the process of making sure that everything is cleaned up. This is my GitHub profile. These are the projects that I have pinned at the moment. Now, these CPP best practices ones, we'll talk about those a little bit more in just a moment. I have my JSON to CPP project, which I talked about in an episode and also talked about a little bit at a talk that I gave at CPP North just 2 weeks ago. And I have this tools project where I've been trying to accumulate all of the different little utility kinds of things that have direct or indirect relevance to this channel, but also just things that I've worked on over the years. I'm putting them all in one place. And then there's the official C++ Weekly repository, and we'll talk about that more again in just a moment. Okay, so this is the C++ Best Practices organization. I created this on GitHub so that I had a top-level place of putting together things like my starter projects, which I know many of you, again, are familiar with, and I've mentioned them several different times. But we have the Cone and CMake boilerplate template project. It's very bare bones. The GUI starter project has SFML, and FLTK and a couple of other things in it. And then there's the FTX UI template, and that is the one that was used for the C++ Weekly Game Jam a couple of months ago. They are all based on the boilerplate project. So the boilerplate is the top level one, and any global changes need to be merged into it. And then I have a shared history with that in the GUI starter template and the FTX UI template. So I have a way of sharing that history between these three projects. So if you open a bug fix or a pull request or something on, say, the FTX UI template, there's a very good chance I'm going to ask you to move that to the boilerplate template project. And the best practices project, you've seen that probably. It has 6,000 stars currently. This is not all of the best practices that are in my book. It's kind of tangentially related. It's largely a collection of C++ tools, but it is a large markdown document that you can check out and you can read here online. Fork if you want to use inside your own organization. Okay, so getting back to upcoming events now, I have the C++ Best Practices book. It's been mentioned at least three times already in this episode. I currently have 4,556 readers on LeanPub alone. That doesn't include the people who have bought it on Amazon. So I thought, that sounds like a pretty good number of people who have presumably read this book. I tried so hard to make it very readable. It is very succinct chapters, very simple, applicable things to your project that you are currently working on. So I decided to go ahead and build on this. And for CVPCon 2022, coming up September 11th through the 16th here, I am going to be offering a pre-conference workshop. And this is called Digging Deeper with C++ Best Practices. It is going to be at the Gaylord of the Rockies in Aurora, Colorado, as a pre-conference workshop from September 10th to the 11th, 2022. And the idea is to like build on these best practices and like really understand, okay, why do we avoid initializer list in some cases? What does the compiler actually do with this code? How does a ranged for loop actually make our code better? That kind of question. It's going to be really digging deeper, understanding the language at a deeper level. So I hope that you sign up for this class and come and check that out. Again, September 10th through 11th, 2022, CVPCon, Aurora, Colorado. So now this gets to where I need your help. If you saw this episode, This Game Teaches C++, then you might know where this is going. I have this project. I have ultimately decided to name it Travels. It is currently in the C++ Best Practices organization. And it is both a game that I'm working on. And if you've been a longtime watcher of this YouTube channel, then you know that there is the C++ Weekly Game Project. Okay, I finally have something that can actually be playable. Boy, it took several years of trying many different things. But I realized as I was working on this that I had created an environment that could also be used for teaching and learning C++. So there are game lesson files in here. And right now I have hacking lessons 0, 1, and 2. And to actually play one of these, you have to go into the project and you have to change the actual game that's being launched. So right now it is launching my game, the thing that I am currently working on for my own fun. And if you comment this line and uncomment this line and hit play, then it comes right back up again. And it is fully designed for being as simple and fast as easy to work with as possible, while also at the same time trying to push people towards best practices. So everything can run inside of Visual Studio Code's window. It is text-based, it uses FDX UI, it has virtually no hardware requirements at all. You can easily run this on a Raspberry Pi class device. Even inside of Visual Studio Code, you can run it on a Raspberry Pi, with the full GUI debugging experience, with sanitizers enabled, with all of the best practices, with Clang Tidy, with Clang Format. It's all here. But where I need your help is, first of all, ideas for what new lessons to create. So you can go ahead and open up issues and say lesson idea and create a lesson idea. And then I also need people who are willing to come in and start to try to create those lessons with me so that we can really make this a good sandbox for learning and playing with C++. And I dig into this some more in the keynote talk that I just gave at C++ on C 2022 called Making C++ Fun, Safe, and Accessible. That's not out yet, but it should be out in the near future. So the Travels game is the first thing I need your help with. The second thing I need your help with is my CPP Weekly project. This is all of the episode ideas that I currently have going. I think I've put in everything in here, even the things that I would consider to be a little bit secret. I just went ahead and put them in here because I want your feedback on this. And you can go in and you can give a thumbs up to any of these episode ideas and say that this is an episode that you would like to see. And I'm going to take this seriously. In fact, as soon as I'm done recording this episode, I am going to record an episode about C++23's Stack Trace Library because it is currently the thing that is on top. And then shortly after that, I will record an episode called What is a Pointer? And it will be for the Fill in the Blank Programmer channel. So please come in here, add episode ideas, try to check and make sure that it's not a duplicate of an existing episode. And then also come in and vote on which ones you would like to personally see by adding a thumbs up to it. As you can see, we've only had a few people involved so far. I would love to get as much feedback as possible on episode ideas. So the last thing then is that I am strongly considering actually doing more regular sponsorship on the channel. And I have gotten many people reaching out to me about wanting to do some sort of sponsorship of the channel. And it's only happened a couple of times so far. So I thought I would make it a little bit easier for everyone. This is my GitHub sponsors page. If you want something that is embedded in the starter project descriptions or in the YouTube video descriptions, then I have things that you can just click on here and become a corporate sponsor, and I'll automatically go in and I'll update all of the videos so that they have a link to your project or your company or your current job opening that you have or whatever, and that'll be in the video descriptions or in the project links themselves in the project descriptions. But if you want something outside of these options here, then please contact me. I am happy to discuss the possibility of sponsorship with anyone. And to be clear, I am looking for things that are a good match for this channel specifically. I want to do things that are respectful to the audience and for the channel. And then I just also want to take a moment again to thank all of my patrons on patreon.com. You all really help keep the channel going. I currently have 162 patrons. It is a huge blessing, and I'm again really thankful for all of you. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope that you can, help out a little bit in helping me decide the direction of these channels, what videos that you would like to see on various topics. And I would really love to start getting some feedback on that travels game so that I can see how I might expand the various lessons in there. And if anyone can play with them and see what you think, that would be awesome. So thanks again, and thanks for watching.